Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whenever you happen to be watching this. Welcome to my gaming table. And as you see, today we have before us a copy of the new release from Compass Games. It's called Battle Hymn Volume 1, Gettysburg and Pea Ridge. This is a new series of Civil War battles from designer Eric Lee Smith. If memory serves me correctly, Smith was the designer of Across Five Aprils, which is considered kind of a classic in its field. And it was a game I was kind of after, and then I had heard that this new series from Compass takes that basic system from Five Aprils and kind of expands it and updates it. And there's some new research about the way Civil War battles were conducted, and that's been incorporated into this game. So I thought we'd just take a look at it and do some unboxing of it, because I don't know, it seems to me that this game has been woefully under-promoted by Compass. I'm on their mailing list, and back when this first was announced, I had pre-ordered it, but it had never really popped up or made the radar in any of the emails I got from them, so I'd have to kind of go in and check on the website every now and then. So maybe they just count on the fact that it's a Civil War game, the audience is going to find it. But just in case you haven't found it, here it is, and I'm going to do an unboxing from it, and just talk about some of the interesting things about it, because having seen the previews of this, this really looks like a beautiful design, and the graphics are just amazing. So here we go. Let's open the box up and check for new game smell. Oh yeah, there you get that sweet smell of fresh printer's ink. There's nothing like it. So I know it's one of my obsessions anyway. So here we have the game, and you have a package of 5 10-sided dice. There's one black and 4 white, and that's kind of interesting. Can't wait to see how that figures into the system. And then this is something that Compass does, and I think they're probably about the only game company that still does something like this. This is their current catalog. This is dated, I don't know when the date on it is, mid-2018. This is their current catalog. Avalon Hill used to do this all the time. They'd have this cool little book that they would enclose. Compass does this as a flyer, and it just happens to fold out into a mat board size sheet, I think. But GMT doesn't do this. I'm not sure Multiman does it. All the other war game publishers that are in business now, I don't think do this. Compass is, like I said, the only one I think that's doing it. Next year, rule set. And this is, Compass has some pretty good production values. It's not real glossy paper like you get with a GMT sometimes, but it is full color. There are lots of examples, case numbering, which is pretty classic. And this includes range, attenuation, and morale, line of sight, all the things you come to expect from a Civil War game. Then, because it is part of a series, we have these special rules. And this is kind of interesting, because there aren't many special rules here. I think just this page here goes into some extra rules about reserve artillery and one of the units, Jenkins Cavalry, and that's actually an optional rule. And basically the rest of this book is scenarios, so they could have almost called this a scenario book, but I'm not gonna second guess. And again, it is pretty pretty chock full of examples and how-tos and things like that. I do need to go back here to the standard rule book just for a second, because I forgot my usual thing. This is a 20-page rule book, and it looks like it's a pretty full 20 pages, but you've got a lot of white space in there. Generous type size for those of us with aging eyes, so the weight of the rules doesn't look very onerous here. Next, we have some play aids. We have two of these. They're a combined play. This is the miscellaneous play aids. There's a unit type, sequence of play, important rules, zones of control. The other side here, we have combat play aids, which is a combat summary, listing of rules to hit chance calculation, combat resolution, hit resolution, things like that. We have two of those. Then we have a couple of sheets with terrain effects on one side and a combat situations chart, morale check table, rally table, and artillery range chart. Now this set of charts, and there are two of them, these two, one for each player obviously, are for the Gettysburg game. And then, as you keep delving into the box, there are two more, and these are basically the same thing. And what these are is these are for the Pea Ridge game. So I thought that was really interesting that there's two separate charts, but that's really kind of smart, the way they've kind of compressed this. Then, of course, the you have the counters, and this looks like a... kind of a rich background here. These obviously are the Union troops and some marker cards like move and turn. You have counters for horses and dismounted cavalry. You have some dummy counters in there and horse counters. And then of course you go into the CSA. And the flip side of these, it looks like a lot of these are for some kind of concealment rules. So that looks interesting. Here's sheet number two, and this features the rest of the Confederate Army. We have hit markers, DM markers, some more horses up here, and then the flip side of this again, we have some of these dummies. These look like control markers because they say control on them, more hit markers and DM, turn move, and an initiative counter and a combat turn counter down here. This looks like this is kind of interesting because these show strength points, and I'm not sure how those are going to come into play. I'm not familiar with the Across 5 Aprils system, but I'm sure this is going to be interesting. More of these DM counters, and this is a double-sided counter. It says firing and moving, and it's either one side or the other. This kind of reminds me of the moved fired counters you get in the Panzer system from GMT, only those are four-sided, and whatever the unit has done is whatever is facing you as you put those down. And then the flip side, more points, you have some demoralized markers. Looks like an interesting system, so can't wait to get this thing on the table. Now here's what's really impressive to me. These maps are amazing, and I'm going to unfold this. This is not going to be able to do you justice, so what I'm going to do is cut to a download I took of the map from the Compass website, and just kind of go over and hit some highlights of it for you. This is a beautiful map, it really is, and this is such a gorgeous map that I made it the background on my laptop computer where I do all my work. It's got a nice wide open look to it. It's got that old timey classic Civil War map feel, and it's got, instead of the full hexes, you'll see it's got the series of crosses or Ys that delineate the hexagons, kind of like the standard tactical series from Multi-Man with the Devil's Cauldron and Where Eagles Dare. The map of the city of Gettysburg itself is amazing looking. It just it's got that old plat map feel to it. What's really interesting about this map, besides being just a real gorgeous work of art for me, if you will look all around the map itself, you will see that there are places for shattered Union units, eliminated. There's a terrain key and a turn marker. On the other side, you have shattered and eliminated Confederate units. The type style is done in a period of that kind of type that kind of evokes that Civil War feel. Just really well done. But what's fascinating about this map to me is all of these charts and tables face the same way. And that tells me that Compass really has their eye on those people like me who buy these games and put them on their table and push counters around and obsess over them. We're mostly solitaire players. And so all of these things are lined out in such a way that it makes it really easy to play solitaire. You don't have to crane your head and look upside down to see what a table is or anything like that. They are all laid out in the same direction. So I thought that was just a really interesting way to approach the map, and I think we'll probably see more of those. Maybe somebody is doing that now and I just haven't seen that. You know, if someone has, let me know. Now I'm gonna just fade to a download I made of the Pea Ridge map. While I look at the actual map here, while I narrate, and again, this is a gorgeous piece of art. To me, this isn't quite as striking as the Gettysburg map. As you can see, this is a lot more heavily forested, with more roads, so heavier terrain features and things like that, more dense. But it is still just very striking. And hats off to the designers of this for giving everything that period look. And as you see, that's it for the box. There's the back of the box, and that's about it for this look at Battlehymn. The only real complaint, the only real ding I would give the design of this thing is the cover. I worked in advertising for many years, so forgive me of this. This is my the one nitpicky thing I have about this is this is the name of the game and the series and which scenarios it is, and it is, to me, it is microscopic. It's easier to see Compass Games down here than it is to read the title. You've got a yellow and a light brown font with the same kind of yellow as highlight in there, and this just fades into the background. Luckily, you can tell from the picture it's a Civil War game, but that is the only thing I would ding this game on. Luckily, I don't think that these games have to worry about being picked up in a game store or anything like that. I think if someone knows Compass Games has a game out and it's in the store, they're going to naturally want to look for it. So as far as being sold online and through online game stores, things like that, this is going to be fine. But let me just reach across here and grab the first game I can reach, which is off of my Market Garden shelf here. It Never Snows. No question about it. So, like I said, maybe I'm just cranky because I don't work in advertising anymore. So, anyway, if that's the worst thing I have to say about this game, this is going to be a great piece of work, and I'm really looking forward to getting it on the table, and maybe I can even get you an AAR on it. So that's my look at Battlehymn Volume 1, Gettysburg and Pea Ridge. Hope it has kind of whetted your appetite for the game if you're into ACW games. I know I'm looking forward to it, and as always, feedback is welcome, so that's what the comments are there for. If you enjoyed this and want to see more, please like and or subscribe. And may all of your die rolls be appropriately high or low. Thanks for watching.